Okay, hello friends, Yusuf here. Welcome to another interesting video. So in this video we're gonna learn two SQL concepts, okay, which is self join and union. So before I go into the topic, right, I'll just explain the scenario and then let's see how we can do that using self join and union. So if you are a beginner or if you already know SQL but still few people might not know this concept, okay, so I thought it would be good to make a video about it. Okay, so before that, the first scenario, what I'm going to do is actually I have a physical file contains three columns, okay, ID, name, and then supervisor column. Okay, so the idea is actually, so these are all the IDs and employee name, say for example, and for this employee, the supervisor is actually the ID 3, which means it belongs to this employee. Okay, so I want an output, okay, to have another column here to state the name of the supervisor. Okay, so ID, name, and for that employee who is the supervisor and his name. Okay, so here what we are trying to do is actually the value is available in the same file, right, but we need to bring for this ID 3, we need to bring the value of the 3, which is the employee 3 here. So this can be done using a self join, and this is actually another thing. Before I go into this, let me finish this one. Okay, so let's do that. Where is that? Yeah, so here I have that file already created, select star from empf. Okay, the same thing. Now I'm going to do it. So select star from empf. Okay, I'll do a join. Okay, and I'm going to join with the same file, so empf. So to differentiate these two, what I'm going to say, this is f1. Okay, join empf f2. Okay, then as per the syntax, there will be a on keyword, and then we need to compare the columns here. So I'm just going to simulate A is equal to B. Okay, assume A and B are column names. Why I'm giving this, because if you take F4, it will work as a prompt. Okay, because the syntax are correct. If you don't give this thing right, it won't work. So that is the reason we give A and B. Okay, okay, so here we give A and B. So here in var condition, I'm just going to select what is the EID, right? So what we are going to do here, we're going to compare these two fields. So f1.eid is equal to f2. Okay, the point is we need to compare this field, which is a supervisor ID, and we need to join that with employee ID of the same table, right? So we need to compare these two. So this and this we should match. Okay, now this is our comparison. So as per the join syntax, the comparison will be coming here. Okay, let me remove this. Control V. So if you do this, what happens? So this is the table, right? And it's joining this column with the employee ID of the same column and then giving the result. So here you can see there is no employee ID 1 coming in. That is because employee ID 1 is having a supervisor 0 and the 0 is not available in the table itself. So but till, say for example, I want the data. Okay, what we can do here, here is the beauty. So we can do, instead of join, we can say whatever, we can say left join. Okay, and also for selecting, I'm selecting field 1, field 2, and then supervisor ID, and then supervisor name. Okay, now you can see the employee ID 1 is having the supervisor ID 0, but there is no name. But for the remaining things, the corresponding name came. Okay, so this is the self join. So join, we'll normally combine two files, but if suppose we want to combine the same file itself, we can do that. Okay, that concept is self join. Now let's go to the another scenario. Okay, this is interesting scenario. Okay, say for example, I have file 1 and file 2. Okay, these two are related to a product file. Okay, these are product ID, and then this is the cost of the product. Okay, so here the thing is, the product is missing. Okay, some of the product from file 1 is missing here, but some of the products are extra in file 2 as well. Okay, and this is the third file which is having a product ID and the price of it. Okay, and you can see there is a product ID called 8, which is not available in both the file 1 and file 2. Okay, so what I want? I want a single output, which is actually a distinct product from these two file. Okay, distinct product from these two file and the corresponding price from the file 3. Okay, so I want this three column, product, cost, and file. Okay, the product should be selected from from the combination of file 1 and file 2, and the corresponding price should be selected from file 3. So how to do that with a single query, that we are going to see. First, let's see how do we first combine these two things. So if you are just a beginner or just know the basic of SQL, right, what we can do, people will think, okay, I'll just take this query and then save it as output, and then I'll append this data, and then if I do a distinct of it, then I'll get the data. Okay, that is one way, but it contains many steps, right? So first let's see how do we do that easily in the using union method. Okay, so select star from file one. Okay, so this is my file one. Okay, great. Now what I can say, select star from file one, union, select star from file two. So if you do union, right, what happens, it combines those two thing and then gives me a single list. But please note that the union will expect the columns to be similar. Say for example, in file 1 I have 3 columns, okay, and file 2 having only 2 columns, then this query will not work. What it will expect, it will expect us to select the columns explicitly. So basically this select statement and this select statement should have the same number of columns, then only the union will work. Okay, so now say for example, if you put just union, right, it will give me the distinct as well. So for example, 4 and 5 is available here also, and then okay, 3, 4, 5 is available in both the things, but it gives me only one. So now let's think, okay, I am having the same 4 and 4, but the value is different. Okay, instead of 40, let me having something else. Let's try that scenario. So select star from file 2 where PID equal to 4. So I'm going to change this value 40. Okay, and let's see what happens. Update file 2, set PCOST equal to 45. Okay, now if I do the union, let's see what happens. Okay, see, here we got the file 1 data. From the file 2 data, the 3 and 5 is not coming because those two are distinct, but 4 is coming because the 4 is not distinct. Okay, so now just I'm having the same query, but I'm just selecting, instead of selecting star, right, I'm just selecting only the PID. Okay, PID, and here also I'm just selecting PID. Okay, now even though the two files are having a different data for the ID 4, right, but if you query this one, right, we'll get the single 4. Okay, because when the union is executed, right, it is comparing, or it is taking the distinct from the select field only. Okay, so here it is selecting the PID field and then checking the distinct value and then providing it. Okay, suppose I don't want a distinct value, I want all the value, then what you can do union all. Okay, then you'll get the vice versa. Okay, fine. So now let's get back to our scenario. So what I want is, I want to combine these two files that we know we can do it using union, and then I should compare it with this file and then get the price data. Okay, now let's do that. I'm going to revert the data back to 40. Okay, let's do that. Okay, now select star from file 1, union, select star from file 2. This gave me the distinct of file 1 and file 2. Okay, now I'm going to take this select star from file 3, because file 3 is this one, and I'm going to join this file against this data. Okay, so please note that when we do join, right, it is not necessary that we should give the file name only. Okay, no, we can give the output of some query also as a join. Okay, so now I'm going to give this as a name, okay, as F, say for example any table. Okay, now I'm joining the file 3 join, this data will be my the joining file as F. Then as per the syntax, we will have on, and we should have a column 1 equal to column 2. Okay, whatever the comparison columns. So what we are going to compare, we're going to compare the PID, right? So file 3.PID, okay, this file's PID is equals to, and this statement is now available as a file F, right? So F.PID. So if you do that, right, what happens, it takes the value from the file 3 and then it's comparing with the value from our expression and then giving the result. Okay, now what I want to select something, right? So I'm gonna do, I want file 3.pid, comma, f is the second file, right? So f dot p cost, comma, again file 3.price, because the column names are like that. Okay, price is cost, okay, actually it's p cost. Okay, enter. You know, I got the combination of file 1 and file 2 and combined with the file 3. Okay, so this is how we can do that. So this is what I want to cover in this video. I hope this helps for you in case if you are working with queries daily, day-to-day activities. Okay, anyway, so that's it for this video. I hope you like it. I'll see you in the next video with different concept. Thanks for watching.